Why is the US taking the lab leaks conspiracy seriously now? I'm Dr. Qiao. The Wall Street Journal published a story in May claimed that three researchers from the lab in Wuhan fell sick in November 2019 and that it could be new supporting evidence of the lab leaks conspiracy. This baseless accusation quickly triggered some US politicians to push the Biden administration to reinvestigate the virus origin in China. How do US media concoct such conspiracies against China? Holding little evidence to fabricate so-called news against China is no new trick for some US media. What they really intend to achieve is to manipulate public opinion against China and hide the truth from the public for political reasons. In an early report by CNN this year, it was alleged that China created an alternative narrative to cover up the real outbreak of the virus. By denying China's efforts to fight the virus, the story claims that the individuals they interviewed are the truth tellers simply because their narratives are different from China's official version. Without solid evidence, such a report makes no progress in slowing down the pandemic in the US, nor can it help boost the economy, but only stirs up hostilities against China. This time, even when the WHO calls for a continued scientific and collaborative approach to be taken towards tracing the origins of COVID-19, the Wall Street Journal story opens no novel discovery of science but the door for right-wing US politicians to pressure President Biden's China policies. Why do some US politicians push for such disinformation? In 2020, as a plot to help him win the re-election, then US President Donald Trump hailed conspiracy theories on COVID-19 origins to pin the blame of the pandemic on China, when Trump himself downplayed the pandemic in the US.
We must hold accountable the nation which unleashed this plague onto the world, China.
As more right-wing US politicians view China as a major competitor instead of a partner of the US, blaming China for the pandemic and the job losses in the country could potentially help them win voters with radically conservative views.
He's doing something right now. He asked his team back in March, right, to do this. This is incredibly important, like his statement says.
As for President Biden, by demanding the US intelligence to look into lab leaks story, he's trying to show his rivals, critics, and the supporters that he is not weak when it comes to policies on China.
We've come so far, but we still have far to go.
The Biden administration has been dealing with mounting pressures and criticisms on issues such as border control, immigration, and economic recovery. China has fully collaborated with the WHO on the investigation of the virus origins.
This whole process is being poisoned by politics.
Instead of utilizing baseless stories by some US media as political schemes against China, new findings about the virus await more internationally collaborated and evidence-based scientific studies.